Hey, Love Island, jump into the 21st century, the same-sex action is lovely. This weekend I battled through vast crowds of ecstatic carousers in Soho, in various states of costume and inebriation, who were reveling in the annual Pride Festival, a public celebration of joy, love, and being out, proud and LGBT. I was there for a pre-wedding dinner with one of my closest friends. His Irish long-term boyfriend proposed in 2015, when same-sex marriage became legal in Ireland. So far so unremarkable. This is Britain in 2017. I'm now engaged to a wonderful man, but have had partners of both sexes in the past. There's a spectrum of sexuality, we're all on it at different points. And also this weekend, like millions of others, I tuned into the ecstatic reality show Love Island. I love reality TV. I can keep up with the Kardashians with ease. I still watch Made in Chelsea, despite mounting horror at my interest in a group of out-of-touch, vain poshos. And I honestly can't wait for the latest episode of Katie Price's latest opus, My Crazy Life, tonight, 10 p.m., Quest Red. Love Island has been talked about everywhere and by everyone. Celebrity fans include the former England cricket captain Michael Vaughan and the rock star Liam Gallagher. It is incredibly popular, ratings hover around 1.7 million, sometimes exceeding 2 million. This is low culture that has seeped into high culture. There was a discussion about the show on BBC Radio 4's PM last week. Nell Butler, the creator of Channel 4's Come Dine With Me, said Love Island had anthropological interest for her. Although she went on to cheapen her point somewhat by praising a challenge where the boys had to identify the girls by feeling their bum cheeks. Writing in The Spectator, James Dlingpole said that, had they made reality TV in late 4th century Rome, he was sure they would have made programs exactly like this. Well, sort of. But in ancient Rome, and Greece, same-sex relationships were common and celebrated. Although as Christianity became more dominant in Europe, so was homophobia. But same-sex relationships on Love Island? Not so much. This year, in fact, nil, zero, nary a flirtation. The show's dominant heterosexuality, the aim is to be in a couple, with faintly sinister Handmaid's Tale-esque boy-girl couplings taking place every so often, seems as fake, vanilla and vacuous as the entire sun, see. Sex and false eyelashes vibe of the show as a whole. Last year a brief fling between bisexual Katie Salmon and fellow contestant Sophie Grodon seemed to change the narrative slightly, only for Sophie to admit later that she faked it. Oh, Sophie. Since then, zip. In a piece in this paper by Tim Johns, the writer Caitlin Moran, who watches with her daughters, told Johns that she thought the show was a template for what happens when you go into the outside world and are trying to find a life partner. And that has been incredibly useful to watch with teenage girls,